This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue.
Actually starts from the point of preparing the land for clearing up to the markets. So when you are looking at agriculture, mostly you are looking from two perspectives. You're either looking at crop products or livestock products. In the case of crop products, which is what most people in the agriculture space in Nigeria are involved with, the value chain starts from the actual act of preparing the land for the crop it is to receive. In preparing the land, we require to be able to clear the land. And after we have cleared the land, you prepare it for cultivation. So there is land clearing and there is land preparation, which is the beginning of the value chain. Subsequent
now,
to
Nigerian
that,
youth
is interested in agriculture. But the Nigerian youth, like you have seen from the agitations of the past few days, is not interested in being a martyr. He's not even interested in being a missionary. He wants prosperity. He wants opportunities open to him. He wants to live the kind of life that the young banker in Lagos or Port Harcourt, or maybe I should be talking about the oil engineer in Port Harcourt, lives, because they have the same brain. They were exposed to the same kind of education, which is supposed to open up opportunities for him. So if we make agriculture such a way that he can depend on it for his livelihood, then the Nigerian youth is willing to farm. But you see, Osiris losses are the losses to agricultural produce that we suffer due to inadequate management after the commodities have been harvested. Inadequate management in terms of the kind of processing we put the commodities through and the kind of storage that we pass the commodities through. Now there are different because there are different post-harvest there are different commodities. Like the doctor just showed us now. We have roots and tubers. We have horticulture. We have grains and oil seeds. We have a number of other commodities that lend themselves differently to storage and processing requirements. She showed us cassava amongst one of the commodities they've developed a storage strategy for. But the question, what my markets are we targeting? And what is the expectation of that market? If I'm looking at fish for my family to be able to eat, or I'm willing to, or I just want to preserve tomatoes so that it doesn't spoil before I can get it to the market, it will be a different proposition from whether or not I'm going to an industrial user who is under some form of regulation and therefore also expects certain standards in terms of what they can collect. You will agree with me that most of the money that smallholder farmers will make is not going to come from consumptive purchases. It's going to come from those entities that require their output as they're
up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel feel at home in this world.